Remasters and remakes are a huge part of the gaming industry, and yes, sometimes they're played out, sometimes they don't need to happen, but if the right games get remastered, things are good. Welcome to Chaos Gaming. We're going to go over 10 games that seriously need to be petitioned to be remastered. Let me know one in the comments that you want, and we're going to start things off at number 10 with Star Wars Republic Commando. How many of you remember this game? Released in 2005, it was a tactical FPS for the PC and the original Xbox. It had you controlling an elite squad of clone troopers during the Clone Wars. It got good reviews, but it didn't sell super well. I mean, it had stiff competition, and many wrote it off as soon as Halo was out. So they wrote it off as a Halo knockoff. But if you played Republic Commando, you know how good of a game it was. The story was great. The combat was really good, and the multiplayer was super underrated. There was originally supposed to be a sequel, but underwhelming sales usually they cancel those things. And the game itself was made non-canon, so it's probably never going to get a remaster. But could you imagine if a Republic Commando was remade on DICE's Battlefront engine? It would be absolutely insane. People love the story. Why not remake the game and make it canon once again? Next up is God of War. Look, I like the 2018 God of War reboot, but I know I'm not the only one who thought it strayed pretty far from the series' roots. That's not a bad thing, it's just different. The original game was released for the PS2 15 years ago, and it redefined the hack and slash genre as a whole. The story was simple, but it was super intriguing, and the combat was silky smooth and extremely addicting. Yes, Kratos wasn't as dynamic as his 2018 reboot, but he was a blast to control, and I know I'm not the only one who would love to see a modern remaster of the original God of War. I believe it was remastered on the PS3, but that was like a decade ago. I know the new God of War series is going in a new direction, but why not remaster the 2005 God of War and package it with the new God of War sequel? Well, yeah. Red Dead Redemption. Now, there are actually rumors floating around this is happening, but I don't want to say anything definite on that either way. Red Dead Redemption launched in 2010. Many consider it to be one of Rockstar's finest creations to this day. You played as a former outlaw, last days of the Old West. You were tasked when hunting down members of your old gang. You guys know the story. The open world was stunning, and the writing was some of the best in any video game. It was one of the best-reviewed games of all time, and Rockstar would be silly to not re-release it on modern hardware for everybody. Like I said, there's actually some leaks and rumors that this could be happening, but Rockstar usually isn't one to remaster their old games, so I'm not sure that I actually buy it. But think of how amazing a Red Dead Redemption remaster would be on the RDR2 engine. Next up is Tony Hawk Pro Skater 3 and 4. We recently got Pro Skater 1 and 2 remastered, so why not 3 and 4? The four Pro Skater games are some of the best sports games ever made thanks to their gameplay. I mean, the levels are great, the soundtrack, the music, everything. The Pro Skater 1 and 2 remaster was a huge success. It sold over 1 million copies in the first 2 weeks on the market, and after how hard of a nosedive the Tony Hawk IP took in the last few years, I think it was a big restart that it needed. I would love to see Pro Skater 3 and 4 get remastered and given the same treatment as 1 and 2 did. Back to Star Wars, Knights of the Old Republic. I mean, come on, speaking of nosedives, BioWare has fallen off the face of the earth over the last 5 years, and they really want to win people back to their good side. Here's the way to do it. Remaster Knights of the Old Republic. Released 17 years ago, do you feel old yet? For the Xbox and the PC, it was a Star Wars RPG developed by BioWare and published by LucasArts, set 4,000 years before the events of the movies. The players make their own custom Jedi, set out to stop the evil Darth Malak if you want to. However, along the way, you have choices. Grow your power, both light and dark. Whatever you want to do, it's huge, it's great. Many consider KOTOR to be one of the best RPGs of the 21st century and definitely one of BioWare's finest creations. Now, I'm not actually sure if this game is canon anymore, but even if it's not, I know a ton of people would love to see it updated with modern gaming rigs. At number 5, The Witcher. Now, the original Witcher game was released 13 years ago, and it flew under the radar. Today, everybody knows The Witcher thanks to the success of Witcher 2 and 3 in the Netflix series, but not nearly as many people have played the original title. The storytelling was really good, as to be expected, but the gameplay was criticized for being too complicated. When a console version was originally in the works, but it was canceled during development, which led many to never experience it at all. Now, with the growth of The Witcher IP over the last decade, I think it would be cool to get the original game touched up a bit with modern hardware and re-release for people to enjoy, and you never know. Maybe people will like the gameplay now that it's gotten some time to age. At number 4, Metroid Prime. Now, we're all waiting around for Prime 4. Perhaps Nintendo could hold us over with a remaster of the original game. Prime was released for the GameCube in 2002, and it perfectly translated to the 2D action platformer adventure that we had in the first one. Metroid Prime was praised for its exploration, its gameplay, its level design, its progression, and it also boasted one of the best soundtracks ever put in a Nintendo game, and that's saying something. In 2009, an enhanced version was released for the Wii as part of the Metroid Prime Trilogy Collection, but I think it's time we got a full top-to-bottom HD remaster of Metroid Prime. I've said it, a couple times. I believe this is one of Nintendo's best exclusives of all time, and with Prime 4 sitting in developmental hell right now, might be a good idea to build some hype with a remaster. At number 3, Battlefront 2 2005. One of the best Star Wars games ever made. Ever. Despite being rushed through development in less than a year, it's often considered to be one of the best shooters of its time. It took the foundation of the original Battlefront, and it made it better. Better graphics, better controls, better content. You could recreate various battles from the original 6 Star Wars films while also rewriting history. There was an original campaign, had a really good story, and there was a fan-favorite Galactic Conquest mode. And there were space battles that still have not been surpassed. And overall, it's one of the best Star Wars games ever made, like I've already said twice. The A Battlefront games have been underwhelming to say the least, but they look and sound incredible, and the gameplay, well, it's just not what the originals offered. So I know I'm not the only one that would love to see an OG Battlefront 2 remade on the current Battlefront engine. At number 2, Dark Souls. Now with the success of the Demon's Souls remake on PS5, this one may actually happen. Dark Souls was released 9 years ago, largely defined the action RPG genre as we know it. The combat? Super unique. The storytelling was something really never seen in a video game before. The story is very vague, and there's not much is told to you at first, but the more you explore the world and you progress your skills, the more you start to understand. Dark Souls was a spiritual successor to Demon's Souls, and since Demon's Souls just got a full remake on the PS5, well, I think this one could get the same treatment after all. Way more people know Dark Souls than Demon's Souls, and I know I'm not the only one who would love to see this game fully remade from the ground up and running at a smooth 60 FPS or higher. And at number 1 today, Silent Hill 2, one of the greatest survival horror games of all time. It is a game that should be preserved, and that means remastering it. Now, Silent Hill 2 was remastered as part of the HD collection 8 years ago. Most people will tell you this is not a good way to experience it. Due to Konami actually losing pieces of the original game code, the Silent Hill HD collection was buggy. With how many people adore the game and want this franchise to make a comeback, I know there would be a market for a faithful remaster or remake of Silent Hill 2. Now, there are rumors that Silent Hills had been uncancelled and is secretly being worked on again, but if Konami wants to build up hype for the Silent Hill franchise one more time, best way to do it is remaster Silent Hill 2 and do it properly, the way it was intended to be enjoyed. It's one of the greatest games of all time. Due to it being so old, it wasn't exactly a bestseller at that time. It's really hard to find a proper copy, actually. So, if there's any game that should be remastered and brought to modern graphical standards, it's Silent Hill 2. There you have it. Let me know where you guys agree and disagree, and name one game you want remastered, and we'll try to make it happen.